So I guess the focus in on previous music intervention studies in the dementia field has mostly been on traditional music therapy, either done on an individual or group setting, that's led by a trained musical therapist, and it's focusing on persons who have moderate to severe Alzheimer's disease. What the results for these type of studies has been mostly that it can, at least on a short-term basis, alleviate different kinds of neuropsychiatric deficits such as depression and anxiety and aggression and so on. But not much focus has been on the earlier stages of dementia and also on different kinds of self-used or caregiver-implemented musical activities, more like musical hobbies. So that was our starting point. So we were interested in seeing whether musical activities such as singing or music listening done together with the caregiver and the person with dementia, could they be used in a rehabilitative context for persons who have mild to moderate Alzheimer's or other form of dementia. So what we devised was a randomized controlled trial in Helsinki, all together with 89 diets of participants, so persons with dementia and their caregivers, who were mostly family members, spouses, or then in some cases nurses that were working closely with the patients. And we were following them up for a duration of 9 months. So this was a three-arm randomization trial. So one of the groups was listening to music, and one of them was singing, and then we had a usual care control group. And we did pre-post assessments before the intervention and after 3 months of intervention, and then 6 months later for a longitudinal follow-up. And the idea in the interventions is something that we call music coaching. So it's not about music therapy, but it's about coaching the caregivers on how to use either singing or music listening to sort of facilitate really everyday goals in the care of the person with dementia. So what kind of music actually is helping them to relax? What is helping them to gain energy? Which songs really are important for individual persons? And taking that as a starting point to try to incorporate music as a part of a daily care for the person with dementia. So this was done in a group setting over 10 weeks, where groups of five persons with dementia and their caregivers met together with a singing teacher or a music therapist, who then introduced them into how to use these musical activities most effectively for the home setting. And then they had these home training, homeworks to be done during the intervention period, with the idea of really rooting this activity as a part of daily life. And what we actually found was that immediately after the intervention period, at the three-month stage, both the singing and the music listening group showed an enhancement in their overall cognitive functioning as measured with the MMSE, as well as with other neuropsychological tests measuring attention and executive functions, and also orientation level. And there was also a positive effect on their mood as a reduction of depression symptoms. But interestingly, for the singing group, there was an additional positive effect on their working memory performance, especially on their verbal working memory, which is something that singing is, of course, tapping quite closely into as respect to music listening only. So that was a really interesting result to get from the study. And singing was also beneficial for the caregivers on relieving the burden that they were feeling, which we were assessing with questionnaires as well. And that was seen also at the longitudinal 9-month follow-up.